Hello students, welcome to this online course of Hydraulics Engineering. So in the previous lecture we have started our new topic, which is gradually varied flow. So I hope you have understood the value of gradually in this chapter. Gradual means the depth of flow is changing gradually, such that you will not be able to figure it out that whether it is changing or not by your naked eyes if you will see a gradually varied flow in the field. So the change is very very gradual, and if the depth of flow is changing, accordingly the other parameters will also change. So today we are going to see the concept which was introduced in the previous lecture, which was the specific energy. So what does this specific energy means? This is very very important concept. Throughout in this chapter and also in the next chapter we are going to use it very frequently. So try to understand this concept here itself, so that in the coming lectures you will not feel any problem. So concept of specific energy, it was introduced by Bachmeteff, and it is very useful in defining critical depth and in the analysis of flow problems. So it was given by Bachmeteff, and it is very much useful in defining critical depth. So what does this critical depth means? So something is critical, some kind of critical thing is happening at this depth. That's why it is defined as a critical depth. And if we are able to define the critical depth, then we are going to analyze the flow very much in detail. It may be noted that while the total energy in a real fluid flow always decreases. So it is very obvious that if there is a flow and the flow is happening in reality, so there will be losses. Losses cannot be minimized to zero. So if flow is happening, some losses will be there in the downstream section. So if this is our bed, this is our datum, and this kind of flow is happening, so in the direction of flow, this is your downstream side and this is your upstream side. So flow is happening like this, okay? So in the direction of flow, there will be losses due to frictional losses provided by the bed, and there are many things are there, like eddies will be there, surface current will be there. So depending upon the amount or the magnitude of these quantities, we can easily say like what is the percentage, but in reality the frictional losses are the major losses. So we usually neglect other losses with respect to frictional losses. So if flow is there, loss is there, that is sure. So unless it is mentioned in the question, you have to assume the losses in the flow. If specifically it is stated that you have to assume the losses to be zero, then only you will say that okay, losses are not there, and that can be a idealized flow. Or it may be like the head provided to the flow, like head provided is, let us say initial head is 100 meters and the losses are, let's say, 0.5 meter. So you can see these are very very, like 0.5 meter is almost negligible with respect to 100 meter. So in that case, we can easily neglect the losses. But unless and until it is mentioned in the question, don't assume like losses are not zero. And the specific energy is constant for a uniform flow. If flow is uniform, so energy is not going to change, and it will be constant for a uniform flow. And specific energy can either decrease or increase in the varied flow. So for total energy, you can say like it will always decrease, but for specific energy, if the flow is uniform, then okay, it is constant. But in varied flow, it can increase, it can decrease, okay? So you have to be very very careful. Don't try to understand this concept very clearly. Like total energy and specific energy, there is a huge difference, and the key difference is total energy is going to change, like it will always decrease in the direction of flow, but specific energy can be constant, can be कैन इंक्रीज और कैन डिक्रीज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द फ्लो एंड टोटल एनर्जी इट एनी टाइप ऑफ फ्लो इफ द फ्लो इज हैपनिंग टोटल एनर्जी इज गोइंग टू बी डिक्रीज इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो. नाउ इफ द फ्रिक्शनल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द फ्लो कैन बी नेग्लेक्टेड द टोटल एनर्जी इन नॉन यूनिफॉर्म फ्लो विल बी कॉन्स्टेंट एट ऑल सेक्शन वाइल द स्पेसिफिक एनर्जी फॉर सच फ्लो will be constant only for horizontal bed channels and in all other cases the specific energy will vary. So this is like basic application of Bernoulli equation. Just try to read the lines and you will easily get what I am trying to say. If the bed is not horizontal, the variation in a specific energy will be there, okay? But for total energy, if the losses are neglected, it will be constant at all the sections. So this you can relate from your fluid mechanics classes. Now the total energy of a channel flow referred to datum is given by this we have already seen. So y cos theta, because the bed will be at a some small angle theta. Alpha is your kinetic energy factor. This you must have studied in your fluid mechanics lectures, and you must have calculated the values also for laminar flow, for turbulent flow, the alpha, and one more parameter was there, beta. So this was momentum correction factor, and alpha is kinetic energy correction factor in generally we used to say, but in most of the cases we will take it as one. If the datum coincide with the channel bed at the section, the resulting expression is known as specific energy. So if you will ask how this expression is going to come into picture, we can say like if the channel bed and datum coincide, if the datum is taken as the channel bed, so the expression of Z will become zero and the resulting expression will be termed as the expression for specific energy, and it is denoted by E, capital letter E. So E is nothing but Y cos theta plus alpha V square by 2G. So this is your pressure head, this is your kinetic head. Cos theta is very very small, theta is very very small, it is almost, we are providing just so that the flow can happen, so it is very very small. So for practical situation we can take cos theta and alpha is equal to 1. So E will be Y plus V square by 2G, unless and until it is mentioned in the question or in the statement that you have to take alpha value, you can take alpha and theta as cos theta and alpha as 1. Now you can see this is the schematic sketch for the gradually varied flow. So this is your energy line, this is the water surface, here you can see theta, and S naught is the bed slope. So this is your datum. If datum is coinciding with the beds, then the resulting equation is going to be termed as E. Okay, so E is taken from the bed of the flow. So if we are converting velocity into discharge, so y plus q square by 2g a square, because velocity is what, q upon a, so v square will become q square by a square. So this is okay at critical depth. So some, let us try to understand what is this critical depth. Critical means something is on the verge of something, something is going to happen. So let us see what is that something. So at critical depth, the specific energy is minimum. So you can see from here, what is happening at a critical depth? A critical depth, the specific energy is minimum. So if you'll try to plot this equation, we will get, let me show you in a bigger form. So this is the definition sketch for specific energy. So this is our, some channel is there, and this is the line of straight line at like 45 degree. This is the curve for your specific energy. So what we are seeing here, we are seeing that for a particular value of energy, if we are seeing like this is the energy, so what we are seeing here, there are two depths possible. So this is your depth. For a particular amount of energy, there can be two depths. For two kind of depths, we can have same energy. Specific energy can be same for two kinds of depth. एंड ओनली एट अ क्रिटिकल पॉइंट ओनली वन डेप्थ इज पॉसिबल. ओके, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस क्रिटिकल डेप्थ फॉर एवरी एनर्जी देयर कैन हैव टू डेप्थ्स. सो दीज टू डेप्थ्स आर टर्म्ड एज ऑल्टरनेट डेप्थ्स. ओके, सो वाई वन दिस कैन बी वाई वन एंड दिस कैन बी वाई टू. फॉर वाई वन एंड वाई टू वॉट इज सेम स्पेसिफिक एनर्जी इज सेम. एंड फॉर क्रिटिकल स्पेसिफिक एनर्जी दैट इज ई सी ओनली वन डेप्थ इज पॉसिबल. सो दिस थिंग यू हैव टू बी क्लियर टू दिस थिंग यू मस्ट बी क्लियर. ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट आर अदर थिंग्स वी आर गोइंग टू डू. सो इफ वी आर डिफरेंशिएटिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वाई एंड इक्वेटिंग इट टू जीरो बिकॉज स्पेसिफिक एनर्जी इज मिनिमम दैट मीन्स इफ वी आर टेकिंग डेप्थ एज वाई सी ई सी विल बी मिनिमम. सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट सम काइंड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ई सी एंड वाई सी. सो लेट अस सी. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ E with respect to Y. So this will become 1 minus Q square upon GA cube. Area is not constant, area is a parameter, it is a function of Y. So it will be differentiated with respect to Y. So it will become dA by dy. From this figure you can see for a small depth dy, dA by dy will become top width. Okay, T will be A into, sorry, A by dy. So T dA by dy will become T. T is the top width of that particular section. So after putting it is equal to 0, you will get this very important relation, that is Q square TC divided by GA cube. Or you can say Q square by G is equal to A cube by T. So this expression we are going to use very frequently in the coming lectures. So I hope this is clear to you. Q square T upon GA cube is equal to 1 for critical depth. You will have Q square TC by GA cube. This whole equation will give you the result as 1. Let us see how we are going to use this equation. So this equation that was Q square by G is equal to A cube by TC is the basic equation governing the critical flow condition. So if in the question it is written like the flow is critical, you can blindly use this equation and you will have no problem. Whatever parameter you are going to calculate using this equation, you will get that very correctly and precisely. Now it may be noted that the critical flow condition is governed solely by the channel geometry. So you can see only discharge and G is constant, Q is discharge, A and T are the geometrical parameters. So only discharge and geometrical parameters are going to control the critical flow condition. Other channel properties such as the bed slope, the roughness do not influence critical flow. So other parameters are not having any role in the flow at a critical condition for a given Q. Q is constant. Now what is Froude number? We have discussed in the first chapter of this subject, which was V by G. So it was V upon G into Y. This was root over. So Y is what? A by T. So if we'll calculate this value from this equation, you will have a magic. What is that magic? So Q square by G is equal to A cube by T. That is okay. So Q square by A square is G A by T. Okay, so what is this? This is nothing but V square is equal to G A by T. So if we'll take the root both the sides, you will have this expression, and this will suggest that this is equal to unity. Froude number at critical condition is unity, that means it is equal to 1. So this is very important, we have derived just now, and by definition also we know that at a critical flow condition the Froude number will be equal to 1. So it is easy, you can see that from equation this, at critical condition Froude number is 1. So critical condition, what are the things? E is minimum, discharge will be maximum, this we are going to see, and Froude number is 1 at critical flow. So these equations you can use very easily if in the question itself it is stated that the flow is critical. If a rectangular section is given to you and it is stated already in the question that the flow is critical, what you can do, you can use this equation is equal to 1, or you can use this equation, put all the values and whatever parameter they are asking in the question, you can easily calculate. So try to revise this chapter because this is very much fundamental, or the coming two chapters are depending on this lecture only, specific energy and its variation. So this is all for today. In the tomorrow lecture, we are going to see how the variation of how we are going to see that at critical flow Q will be maximum. E is minimum, that is okay, we have derived, and Q will be maximum. So we will see this in the next lecture. So this is all for today. Thank you.